In 1910, Hendrik Cheap led a hunting expedition from the Lower Fish River, where his clan was settled at the time, and moved northeasterly across the Lion River. They arrived at this uninhabited fountain that had black mud, which Cheap named Nqwais, meaning the one with black mud. None of the eight original Nama clan at the time had claimed ownership of the area. Nqwais became an economic hub soon after, largely due to the progressive and managerial skills of Hendrik Cheap. For 22-year-old innocent Peter, Cheap for him was the Moses of his people.
Many a times I link Hendrik Cheap to currently the battle that we are in to empower young people, and how as a student leader, as a youth leader, we are always on the ground trying so much to ensure that our young people are equipped with the skills, with the knowledge. So that's exactly what Hendrik Cheap did. He saw the condition his people were in. He saw that no, this is where my people are going to die, and I cannot allow this as a leader. So he took his people and searched heaven and earth to ensure that he finds a water source.
Peter, who is a regional executive committee member of NANSO and a fourth-year Bachelor of Business Administration student at UNAM Southern Campus, says Hendrik Cheap was instrumental in shaping his identity.
The story of Hendrik Cheap and his people should teach us one thing, that giving up is not an option. That indeed, at the end of the tunnel, there is light always. So I applaud and speak to my young people and say that let's stand up. Let's use each and every little bit of opportunity we get from whatever individual, from the private sector, from government. Let's take that opportunity and make the best out of it. Let's make blood mud out of it.
For Vivian Deku, a board member of the National Youth Council, the late Mandela Kapere is her hero.
The late Honorable Mandela Kapere, wow, what a gentle giant, a father figure. He was just so many things all in one. He has taught me and he has encouraged actually my political career to become where I am today. Mandela would always tell me that, Vivian, whatever you do, remember you are the servant of the people. You serve the people. You don't serve yourself. So you need to do what's best for your people, for the people. And that was so inspiring, just to think that how much work he had to do.
The two youth leaders urged their peers to learn Namibian history, remain motivated, and position themselves to contribute to the country's developmental goals. Na Tangwejimi, NBC News, Kiet Manswap.